हेलो किड्स, शुभा मंगलम। दिस इज हेमलता एट लिटिल स्कॉलर हाई स्कूल, टेकिंग अप क्लास 10th बायोलॉजी। वी आर इन लेसन नंबर 1, न्यूट्रिशन द फूड सप्लाइंग सिस्टम। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एक्टिविटीज टू एक्सपेरिमेंट्स रिलेटेड टू प्रेजेंस ऑफ स्टार्च, एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन द प्रिस्टलीज एक्सपेरिमेंट टू प्रूव दैट एयर इज ऑल्सो नेसेसरी फॉर द प्रोसेस ऑफ फोटो सिंथेसिस। एंड नाउ वी हैव टू कम टू द पॉइंट रिलेटेड टू लाइट एंड फोटो सिंथेसिस, वन ऑफ द मेटीरियल और वन ऑफ द फैक्टर विच इज एसेंशियल फॉर फोटो सिंथेसिस। इनिशियली ड्यूरिंग प्रिस्टलीज टाइम मेनी मेनी एक्सपेरिमेंट्स वेर गोइंग ऑन, एंड द साइंटिस्ट डिड नॉट हैड मच मोर क्लैरिटी अबाउट द what is actually about the energy, how does it works and all. But eventually as the studies went on, they could make out that yes, there is the impact of energy in the process of photosynthesis, and it has been observed that there is a release of energy, there is a release of energy when carbon dioxide and water are produced, that is when oxygen combines with carbon or oxygen combines with hydrogen, it is giving out carbon dioxide and water and energy is released. Then the scientist started thinking what would happen if the reverse takes place, what would happen if the reaction is reversed. Then it has been learned that yes, the evolution of oxygen will occur, but it requires absorption of the energy. Evolution of oxygen occurs, but it requires the absorption of some energy, then only it is possible. Okay, children, then what happened? That Dutch scientist Jan Ingenhuis in the year 1779, he also studied a lot regarding the effect of light or energy in the process of photosynthesis, and he said that studied the way in which the plants produce the oxygen. He studied that yes, plants are able to produce oxygen, and this can happen only in the presence of light, and this can happen only in the presence of light. And to prove this, he has conducted an experiment using an hydrilla plant. And hydrilla plant, it is an aquatic plant, it is taken into study so that it is easy for the observation. Okay, so when he has taken the hydrilla plant and conducted an experiment and exposed this hydrilla plant to the light energy, he observed that some bubbles have been evolving, or some bubbles were released at the green part of the hydrilla plant, and he confirmed that whatever the bubbles which were evolved, that is nothing but the gas and that is nothing but oxygen. Okay, this has been, this information was given by Jan Ingenhuis. Then in the 20th century, Engelmann, he said that he also worked a lot on the concept of light, and he has used the strands of the algae. He has used the strands of the algae and he exposed these strands to the light. That is nothing but the rainbow colors. Okay, and he also taken the oxygen sensitive bacteria and he also exposed that to the light. Then he observed that the bacteria was getting accumulated, or that means the bacteria was much collected, or it was crowded more at the light where red than blue rays were illuminated. Okay, children, and that is how again it gave to the further studies to the complex compound called as pigments. And studies later further continued for to study the compound substances called pigments. Okay, children, now let us move on to one of the activities on page number 7, which proves that oxygen is produced during photosynthesis. Now for this setup, we need two setups for this. For this experiment to conduct, we need two setups. Why? Because one we will conduct in the presence of light and one in the dark, which gives us a clear result and we can come to an exact conclusion. Now for this particular experiment to be done, we need a beaker filled with water and you need a funnel. In this funnel you will fix up the hydrilla plant and you will take one test tube again filled with water, and very carefully you will invert the test tube on the stem of the funnel. Okay, children, I'm repeating it again. You need to take a beaker filled with water, a funnel with hydrilla plant, and you need to take a test tube. Again, it is also filled with water, and very carefully you will invert this test tube on the funnel stem. Okay, now you will leave this setup, one setup in the dark and one setup in the light, and after 3-4 hours you will be observing that the level of water will be slowly coming down, and at the top of the test tube, in the bottom of the test tube, here we say this is the inverted test tube, the test tube inverted. Okay, so at this part some gas is accumulated and we can see some bubbles arising from the hydrilla plant. From where the hydrilla plant is there, from there we can see that some bubbles are arising, and all these get accumulated at this portion of the test tube. Now, slowly you will take up the test tube, okay, and immediately, very carefully, you will lift the test tube, and immediately you will close the test tube with the thumb. You will close the test tube with the thumb so that whatever the gas which is there may not get just mix up with the external air. Okay, then what you will do is, you will ask your friend to bring one mastic at the mouth of the test tube, and then you open the test tube. Now this match stick which is glowing turns into flames. Okay, children. Okay, now here you are taking the test tube very slowly, then you will bring the mastic, which is glowing mastic, at the mouth of the test tube, and you will observe that in few fraction of the seconds it turns into flames. Okay, now this test proves that the liberated gas is nothing but oxygen. Understood, children? The liberated gas is nothing but oxygen. The precaution what we need to take in this particular experiment is, we should always check that the water level is above the stem of the funnel. The water level in the beaker should be above the stem of the funnel, and the same bubbles you will not find in the setup which you have kept in the dark. That means, yes, in the presence of light, air is there which is freely flowing into the beaker, water is there, plant is there, sunlight is also exposed, hence all the necessary requirements are provided for the hydrilla plant, and hence it is able to undergo the process of photosynthesis and give out oxygen. This test proves that the evolved gas is oxygen. Next, now on page number 8, you have one more activity related to the sunlight necessary for photosynthesis. In this particular experiment, again we are taking a very healthy potted plant, and we are keeping this potted plant into a dark for 3-4 days so that whatever the starch which is stored in the plant is used by the plant. That means we are de-starching the plant. Then to one of the leaf, here we are taking the leaf which are little wider in nature or broad in nature, so that it is easy for us to conduct the test. Now you will select one of the leaf to which you will attach a black paper. You will fix a black paper, and before fixing the black paper on the leaf, you will make some design on it. Okay, children, you will make some design on it, and then it is very carefully fixed to the leaf, and this setup is again left in the sunlight for a matter of 3-4 hours. Next, after that, this particular leaf is plugged and it is tested for the presence of starch, and you all of you know how to test the presence of starch. It is nothing but by putting the leaf in the methylated spirit, giving it a water bath, and then adding iodine or betadine solution. The same procedure what you have learnt in activity 1 is followed here to test the presence of starch. Now you will be observing that the part of the leaf which is exposed to sunlight. That is, you can see the shaded portion here. Okay, this is exposed to sunlight, and this design, the shape of an S, is also exposed to the sunlight, and this part, when tested with iodine, turns to blue black, whereas this portion, the plain portion which was covered with black paper, will not turn to blue black. This shows again that here the light rays were falling on the leaf, hence it was able to produce the starch or glucose. Hence this has been converted into blue black color, whereas this black paper, where the leaf which was covered with black paper was not exposed to sunlight, and hence it could not, and that part could not undergo the process of photosynthesis. So this is what we, for this present class, we have seen here today. In today's session, we have seen about the light and photosynthesis, and about the scientists who gave their concepts out, and we have seen about the two experiments which are essential factors of photosynthesis. In next class, we will move a little further into the chlorophyll, structures of leaf, chloroplast and all. Before we move on to the next class, please go through all the activities. And whenever you are writing an experiment, make sure that you are writing the aim. Aim means what is the purpose you are conducting the experiment for, what is the material or the apparatus you need, and you will, if in case for this experiment you require some chemicals like betadine solution and all, so you mention the chemicals required, then you mention the procedure, observation and inference, and supported with the diagram. Okay, Jira? This is the way you need to present your experimental answers in the exam. Thank you.